Dalton Trumbo is considered one of the best screenwriters of all time. In his life, he wrote over 60 screenplays, most of which he was uncredited for. But I'll get to that later. Trumbo was born and raised in Colorado. After he graduated high school, he moved with his family to Los Angeles. He enrolled at the University of Southern California, but he didn't have enough credits to graduate. It was in college when he truly found his love for writing. In 1934, Trumbo was hired by Warner Brothers, where he read different plays and novels and advised on their movie potential. This eventually became a job as writing scripts for B-movies. He then moved from that to writing A-list scripts for studios all over. In 1940, he received his first Oscar, nod for Kitty Foyle. He was very successful from that point on, writing big scripts for A-list celebrities. This changed in 1947. Trumbo had recently joined the Communist Party in 1943. In 1947, the House Committee on Un-American Activities, or the HCUA for short,
is investigating alleged communist influence and infiltration in the moving picture industry must not be considered or interpreted as an attack on the industry itself.
Called in 10 men for questioning under suspicion of injecting communist and un-American ideals into films. These men were Alva Bessey, Herbert Biberman, Lester Cole, Edward Dmytryk, Ring Lardner Jr., John Howard Lawson, Albert Maltz, Samuel Ornitz, Adrian Scott, and Dalton Trumbo, who were nicknamed the Hollywood Ten. The men refused to answer any questions and were all blacklisted. This took a toll on Trumbo. Throughout his blacklist, he wrote many scripts under false names and sold them for money. In 1953, he wrote the script for Roman Holiday using the front Ian McClellan Hunter.
Hard idea.
Let's see you do it.
The script won an Oscar, which surprised Trumbo. Similarly, in 1957, his script, The Brave One, written under the name Robert Rich, was nominated for and won an Oscar.
Really?
Yes, really.
That's crazy.
The nominations for Best Motion Picture Story are Robert Rich for The Brave One, Leo Katcher for the Eddie Duchin story, Jean-Paul Sartre for The Proud and the Beautiful, and Cesare Zavattini for Umberto D. The envelope, please. The Brave One, Robert Rich.
In 1958, Kirk Douglas went to Trumbo and asked him to write the script for Stanley Kubrick's When the film was released, Trumbo was given full credit. This marked the end of Trumbo's blacklist.
Well, Dalton Trumbo, I didn't exactly call him back.
You give him the chance.
Because he was writing all the time, but always under a false name. And the hypocrisy of that disturbed me. So I said, look, I want to use Dalton Trumbo, and I insist on using his name. I had a lot of resistance from the studios, but finally I said, I won't make the picture unless we can use his name. And we used his name, and the earth didn't fall apart. And after that, I'm proud to say that it broke the blacklist.
Trumbo continued writing scripts, including Johnny Get Your Gun and Papillion.
Steve McQueen, Dustin Hoffman.
Until his death in 1976. In a time of fear and paranoia, Trumbo continued to write instant classics, even under suspicious eyes. This is why I think Trumbo is one of the best and most influential screenwriters of all time.
I'm Spartacus!
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 I'm Spartacus!